I'd like to say this is absolutely fantastic that all the students, those trade unions and the UC Union for turning out today in support of the struggle that we're all engaging in currently. I'd like to say that we have full support both from the R&T Trade Union and also from the Liverpool Trade Union Council. I'd also like to express solidarity not only to those students here today, but those students who were out last week, and those many thousands of students who have taken to occupations around buildings, university colleges and universities around the country in the fight to defend what should be a right, and that is free education for all. Free education. Free education that doesn't sorry you with years of debt, with years of misery, with not even able to provide for yourself or your families. It's an absolute disgrace that we're in a country that's run by 18 multi-millionaires who don't care about anyone here today, who don't care about vast swathes of society. Their only interest is the interest of big business protecting their profits, not protecting ordinary working people at large in society. They're quite prepared to attack every single one of us today, and we must stand up and fight with all our might. And their policies and ideologies that are destroying this country. And let's make it quite clear. Let's give Karen, Clegg and the Labour Party that introduced tuition fees, let's never forget that. They're the party that introduced tuition fees, that we say no to tuition fees, no to cuts in the EMA. And that's the reality. And we go on further than that. It's a wider struggle, but we widen that out to say no to cuts in public services, no to the savage brutal attacks on the most vulnerable society, no to cuts in social services, no to cuts in welfare state, no privatisation of the NHS. But we've got to realise, why are we in this mess? And the reality is, we're in this mess because of the banking crisis. And let's remember, it was the banking crisis, the budget deficit increased by four times due to the banking crisis. And if the reality is, the only way the likes of Karen and Clegg can protect their profits, protect the policies of big business, is by getting everyone else, all the working class, the students, and all the ordinary working people in society to pay for it. They want to take this country back to where they can pay massive bonuses, massive profits, massive dividends to shareholders, and they can only achieve that by cutting the welfare state, by cutting the EMA, by increasing tuition fees, by cutting railway services, by cutting health services, and it's an absolute disgrace, and we have a duty to resist. A duty to take part in civil disobedience against these policies of outright capitalism that are destroying every single one of us. And come on again. We have the future here today in our hands.
Yeah.
And we've got to build on this movement. We've got to work with all you today and the trade union movement. Saying we ain't having you, Cameron and Clegg, dictating to us, increasing the profits of business. We want a society that provides for all. And what we're witnessing at the moment is a complete failure of the capitalist system. And the only way that the capitalism can be changed is by fighting for a better system. And that system is going to be a socialist society, where they're based on the needs of all greed and business. And all the likes of Karen and Clegg and the other 16 millionaires who are preaching to us on a daily basis, what a disgrace they are! So that's it, leave here today, and we say no to Green, no to Karen, no to Clegg, and let's build a society where all of us are helping each other out, and let's move forward today. And let's have a bigger turnout, bigger demonstrations, bigger applications, and fight with all our might to resist these attacks on every single one of us. Thanks very much.